أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الخالق Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been described as Al-Khaliq, meaning the creator. This is the 11th name within the Asma'ul Husna, which attribute to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who creates something from nothing, and He determines and creates in proper proportion and measure of each thing. He created each thing with a purpose, and that ultimate purpose of each and everything being created and the purpose of humankind being sent onto earth was to gain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to obey Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who plans and determines how, when and where to create. The one is Allah, whose works are perfectly suited, appropriate, fitting and proper in nature. Allah is the ultimate creator. Now we have creators within this life who make things which most will be around us today. Most of the things, for example, furniture. But this is unlike the creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has been ascribed with the name Al-Khaliq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directly and indirectly is the creator of all things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created humankind directly, so He was the direct creator of humankind. But then these humans which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, they made, for example, furniture and other materialistic things around us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indirectly and directly is the creator of all things seen, unseen, things which have been created, things which are being created, and things which will be created. It has been said that whoever recites the name Al-Khaliq, meaning the creator, at night time, the recitation of this name will make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create an angel for him, subhanallah.